Meantime, Nishant Fadia, the COO of Prime Focus, now joins us. Do remember that Jefferies has come out with quite a positive note on the company, on the industry as a whole when it comes to media. Mr. Fadia, good morning, or rather good afternoon. Thanks so much for joining us on ET Now. You know, like I was saying, Jefferies is very upbeat on the company, is very upbeat on the industry, and they believe that Prime Focus specifically is uniquely positioned to sort of benefit from offshoring advantages. So firstly, take us through the view of the space as a whole and how India stands, and you know, to share the opportunity, what it holds for your company as well.
Sure, thanks for having me on the show. So, you know, we've over the past few years, you know, back going back to 2007-8, always sort of believed that India had the potential, capability and expertise to get this, I wouldn't call it offshoring, but, you know, to get work done for Hollywood in a certain cost-efficient manner. And I think that's sort of starting to bear fruit in the last couple of years, and specifically for us, after we did the transaction with Double Negative, who's a tier one VFX player, and we've seen you know, that work sort of slowly coming to India, and over the past 2-3 quarters, obviously working on huge tentpole you know, movies like we just finished Transformers, we just did Wonder Woman, we're doing Dunkirk, Geostorm, Blade Runner, you know, all tentpole Hollywood franchises or, you know, Hollywood movies. And that's, you know, I believe that this is, we're just at that point where this is about to, you know, just, you know, get India on that playing field.
What is the current cash on your books, and do you see the cash flow position improving?
Yeah, we have a net debt of about 1250 crores, which has been brought down over the last 3-4 quarters. We've sold a couple of non-core assets, done a couple of refinancings, and that's helped the cash position. And we, you know, look to sort of reduce net debt over the next 12 to 18 months as well.
Okay. Now, you know, another interesting point that, you know, the brokerage house has made is that your market share has doubled in 5 years, and there is potential for higher engagement with top studios, etc. as well. And in light of that, they're expecting the EBITDA to nearly double in the next 3 years. That's approximately by FY20. Do you think that, you know, you would be up to task, and what would drive this growth in the EBITDA?
You know, clearly, without specifically commenting on an EBITDA number, clearly the trajectory is there. We've seen growth from FY16 to FY17 from 335 crores of EBITDA to about 500 crores of EBITDA. Clearly we are on that trajectory. I think what drives this EBITDA growth largely is, like I was mentioning earlier, you know, moving some of the work to India, you know, that clearly leads to margin expansion, top line anyway. You know, with the brand of Double Negative, we've got a, you know, one of the best order book years we've ever had. We've got about totally on the group about $450 million of order book going ahead next couple of years. This year itself, on the creative services business, we have a very good order book, about $250 million. So that bodes well for us, and this year is just focusing on executing that order book, pushing up efficiency and output in India, scale if required. We already got to a certain scale, but if the revenue demands it, we can do more. So I think that's, you know, obviously the leading cause. As more and more work happens in India, efficiency will go up, you know, and that sort of will lead to the margin expansion, which I guess Jefferies is talking about.
Okay, and just one final question. The acquisition of Double Negative in 2014, according to brokerages, has propelled the company to the top four global VFX providers. What are the synergies from the acquisition, and will you continue to hold on to this position? Like, what is it that you can guide for as a combine?
Oh, certainly. I think, you know, that was a great transaction for us. You know, DNEG, Double Negative is a top tier VFX house. In the last 3 years, they won 2 Oscars for Best Visual Effects for Interstellar and Ex Machina. So clearly, you know, one of the most revered companies out there, and our combination with them, adding the India piece to that, and, you know, sort of taking that business to the next logical level of scale and size, we, you know, expanded to Vancouver and now Montreal as well. as far as double negative is concerned, and obviously the India piece is happening simultaneously. There's certainly something which we look forward to and building on that.
Okay. All right, Mr. Fadia, clearly the street seems to be liking what you're saying. Your stock is spiking up as we speak. But thank you for joining us, helping us understand what exactly is transpiring in the industry, company specific as well. And wish you all the very best for the coming quarters. That's Prime Focus for you. Spiking up in trade, higher by about 1.5%. But the IT index underperformed the Nifty by nearly 9% in the June quarter, probably reflecting the muted quarter that we are staring at. Sunita Nagpal joins us to take us through the pulls and pushes.